Welcome. If you've just been told you have a TIRADS 3 thyroid nodule, you probably have a lot of questions. Let's walk through everything you need to know, step by step, calmly, clearly, and confidently. Here's what we'll be covering today. We'll start by understanding what a TIRADS 3 nodule really means. Then, we'll talk about the actual risk of cancer and why you likely don't need to panic. After that, we'll explain when a biopsy is needed and when it's safe to simply watch and wait. We'll also look at treatment options if necessary. And finally, we'll end with how you can support your thyroid health and monitor wisely. If you find this information helpful, please consider subscribing to our channel. It helps more patients like you get the clear answers they deserve. When you hear that you have a TIRADS 3 thyroid nodule, it's very normal to feel uncertain or even a little anxious. You might wonder, what exactly does this mean for me? Let's go through everything you need to know calmly and clearly so that you feel fully informed and reassured. A TIRADS 3 nodule is something we find when looking carefully at your thyroid gland with an ultrasound scan. In simple terms, it's a lump inside the thyroid that looks mostly harmless, with only mild features that catch our attention. The TIRADS system, which stands for Thyroid Imaging Reporting and Data System, helps doctors decide how concerning a thyroid nodule might be, based purely on how it looks during the ultrasound. We look at specific features. Is the nodule solid or filled with fluid? Are the edges smooth? Are there tiny calcium deposits? Is it darker than the surrounding thyroid tissue? Based on these details, each nodule is scored and categorized. A TIRADS 3 nodule is in the mildly suspicious category. Mildly suspicious doesn't mean dangerous. It simply means it's worth keeping an eye on over time. But the chance of it being cancerous is very low. Now, why did your doctor order an ultrasound in the first place? Maybe you had a swelling in the neck, a change in your voice, or it was found by chance during a scan for another reason. Ultrasound is safe, painless, and it's the best first tool we have to look closely at the thyroid gland. When a nodule is labeled TIRADS 3, it usually has very gentle features on the scan. Maybe it's a little darker than the normal thyroid, or it's mostly solid instead of being fully cystic, but it doesn't have worrying signs like sharp, irregular borders or tiny specks of calcium. And the big question on everyone's mind, is it cancerous? The short answer is almost always no. The risk of cancer in a TIRADS 3 nodule is very low, around 2-5%. That means over 95% of these nodules are benign, harmless, and non-cancerous. Understandably, you might still feel worried when you hear the word nodule. But just remember, TIRADS 3 is on the gentle side of the scale. Most of the time, we simply keep an eye on it, with no need for urgent procedures or surgery. Now you might wonder, are there any symptoms that would make us more concerned? Generally, most TIRADS 3 nodules do not cause symptoms at all. But if you ever notice sudden growth, changes in your voice, trouble swallowing, or a lump that feels very firm and fixed, it's important to tell your doctor. These symptoms don't automatically mean cancer, but they do tell us that it's worth reassessing carefully. Now, let's talk about biopsies. One of the most common questions is whether you'll need a biopsy for a TIRADS 3 nodule. In most cases, the answer is no, at least not right away. TIRADS 3 nodules are usually safe enough to monitor without needing to take a sample. So, when do we actually consider a biopsy? The decision is based mainly on the size of the nodule. If your TIRADS 3 nodule measures 2.5 centimeters or larger, that's about the size of a small plum, your doctor may recommend a fine needle aspiration biopsy, just to be absolutely sure. But what if the nodule is smaller? If your nodule is between 1.5 centimeters and 2.4 centimeters, we usually do not biopsy right away. Instead, we recommend regular follow-up ultrasounds to carefully monitor it over time. And if your nodule is even smaller, less than 1.5 centimeters. In most cases, no active follow-up is needed. These tiny TIRADS 3 nodules are extremely unlikely to cause any trouble. So depending on the size, your doctor will personalize the plan for you, whether it's no follow-up, spaced out ultrasounds, or in rare cases, a biopsy if it's larger. Now, about timing, if your doctor recommends monitoring, your next ultrasound is usually scheduled for around 1 year later. This gives us enough time to spot any meaningful changes while avoiding unnecessary scans too soon. If everything looks stable at the 1 year mark, future scans might be spaced every 2 to 3 years. This gentle rhythm of follow-up ensures you're well protected without putting you through constant testing. But what if the nodule grows? We pay close attention to growth. A small change is normal, especially when different technicians or machines are involved. However, if the nodule grows by 20% or more in its diameter, that's when we start thinking about a biopsy, even if the nodule still looks low risk. It's important to remember that growth alone doesn't always mean cancer. Some benign nodules can grow slowly over time, but significant growth deserves a closer look, just to be sure we're not missing anything important. Sometimes patients ask, is there any chance my thyroid nodule might shrink or even disappear without treatment? And the good news is, yes, it's definitely possible. Some TIRADS, 3 nodules, especially those that contain a lot of fluid or simple tissue, can gradually shrink or even vanish over time on their own. This is why, in many cases, the best first step is simply watchful waiting with periodic ultrasounds. Now, let's say your nodule does grow over time. What then? Even if growth occurs, it doesn't always mean surgery or drastic action. The first step would usually be to perform a biopsy to better understand the nodule's nature. If the biopsy shows that the nodule is still benign, but it's causing pressure symptoms like difficulty swallowing, a feeling of tightness, or visible swelling, your doctor might talk with you about surgical options to remove the nodule. Surgery is very rare for TIRADS 3 nodules. It's usually reserved only for special cases, such as when the nodule becomes uncomfortably large, or if biopsy results are unclear or suspicious. Some patients also wonder if there are medications that can shrink thyroid nodules. Right now, there are no medicines specifically proven to shrink TIRADS 3 nodules reliably. Occasionally, if someone has an underactive thyroid, doctors might prescribe thyroid hormone therapy. But this is not standard treatment just for the nodule itself. That brings us to another important question. Are thyroid blood tests helpful for managing a TIRADS 3 nodule? Blood tests like TSH and free T4 are very useful to check how well your thyroid gland is working. However, blood tests cannot tell us whether a thyroid nodule is cancerous or not. They're part of the full picture. But when it comes to nodules, it's the ultrasound appearance and sometimes a biopsy that give us the answers we need. Another question that often comes up is, can my TIRADS 3 nodule get worse over time? Could it turn into a TIRADS 4 or TIRADS 5? The answer is, very rarely. Most TIRADS 3 nodules stay exactly the same year after year. However, in a small number of cases, a nodule might develop new features over time, such as becoming more irregular, showing small calcifications, or changing shape. And that could lead to a higher TIRADS category. This is exactly why gentle monitoring with ultrasounds is recommended. It's not because we expect problems, but because early detection of changes gives us a chance to act, if needed, long before anything serious develops. Some patients also wonder whether they should seek a second opinion after a TIRADS 3 diagnosis. If you feel very unsure about the classification, or if you're uncomfortable with the information you've received, it's completely reasonable to discuss it with another doctor. However, it's good to keep in mind that TIRADS 3 nodules are usually straightforward, and a second opinion may not change the overall management plan. Also, consider the practical aspects like the cost and time involved, since careful monitoring, rather than urgent action, is the usual path forward. Now, stepping back a little, how common are TIRADS 3 nodules? The answer is very common. As more people have ultrasounds for different reasons, small thyroid nodules are discovered more and more often, and many of these are classified as TIRADS 3. In fact, the vast majority of these nodules are completely harmless. Waiting for follow-up scans can naturally cause some anxiety. If you find yourself worrying between appointments, remember that the odds are overwhelmingly in your favor. Keeping to the follow-up plan, staying active with your normal daily life, and focusing on positive activities like exercise, hobbies, or time with family can make the waiting time much easier and less stressful. It's always important to take care of your emotional well-being, just as much as your physical health. Now, what happens if you skip your follow-up appointments? Even though TIRADS 3 nodules are mostly stable, missing your scheduled ultrasounds could mean that a rare change goes unnoticed. It's like gently watching over a quiet garden. Most days, there's no change, but checking in regularly helps catch any unexpected weeds before they grow too big. Following your doctor's advice ensures that you stay protected, with complete peace of mind. Finally, what about lifestyle changes? While no specific diet or supplement has been proven to shrink thyroid nodules, maintaining a balanced diet, avoiding excessive iodine supplements, quitting smoking, and managing your stress levels can all contribute to better overall thyroid health. These healthy habits are good for your whole body, not just your thyroid. And they help you stay strong and resilient no matter what your thyroid scan shows. Thank you for spending your valuable time with us today. If you found this explanation helpful, please like the video, share it with others who might need it, and leave your questions or your experiences in the comments below. We're here to support you every step of the way.